What's the next appropriate step? Consultation. Not sure what it is. Vancomycin, powerful antibiotics. Okay, preventive adjuvant. Okay, that would be like asthma, COPD. Ciprofloxacin. I mean, some kind of gastrointestinal germ. Needle decompression. Okay, interesting. That's got to be tension pneumo. Okay, let's read. Okay, 76-year-old from nursing home with a history of dementia. Okay, so I'm not going to get much history. Fine. She presents with decreased mental status from baseline and a fever. Okay, fine. She's tachycardic of 120. She's Fahrenheit 102. So she's got an infection brewing. Timeout. Does that make you want to throw any of these stuff away? So any of these, just based on what I've shared with you, says, that's less likely. So if we're using preventive adjuvant, who are we typically using those on? Asthma COPD. Now, do asthma COPD normally have fevers? Can we agree not normally? I mean, I'm not saying it's not normal. If needle decompression, when are we doing that? Tension pneumos. Are they normally febrile? I'm not saying we throw those out yet, but I'm just kind of going, listen, I already read through the choices, so this is something I'm just thinking about. Okay, as I go. Okay, 24, so she's febrile, breathing fast, her blood pressure's okay, her sats are okay, not great, but yeah, for 76, yeah, you know, yay, 76. Okay, she's got a weight count of 16,000, chest x-ray was done. What's the next appropriate step? Don't say anything, think about it. What do you see in the next ray? Don't say anything, think about it. Don't say anything, think about it. What do we do next? Ooh, wait a second. What is a big treat here? Is that, or is something up here? Or what the, what do we think? Ooh, is this like, ooh, what is going on here? Colleagues, you obviously, this line right here, something perf down here. They got free ear into the belly, surgical consultation. They have to go to the OR. This is pneumoperitoneum. What probably perf? Probably diverticulum. Probably. This person needs, they do need antibiotics. They need potent belly antibiotics, but this person needs to go to the OR. Large boy V, Foley catheter. First and foremost, with this particular patient, is she DNR? Is her family I should call? Hey, your mom has a burst bowel. Do you want your mom to go to the OR? So I'm going to run this by family. Time out. Let's talk about consent for a second. Make sure we have dilated in consent. There's only two forms of consent. That's it. Informed or implied. That's it. If they give you a professional practice question about consent, there's only two forms. So if they don't say informed or implied, they may use some weird verbiage. To physician consent, emancipated consent. Those aren't real terms. They're making them up. Now, what is informed consent? You need two things to have informed consent. You need an adult. So Justice Cardoso, who came up with this decision, he said this, you need to have two things. You need to be of adult years and sound mind. If you're of adult years and sound mind, you can determine your own health care. So when you document in your charts, those are the two magic words, adult years and sound mind. Well, if they're 40 years old, of course, we're adult. Are they of sound mind? Okay, well, who determines if they're of sound mind? This guy. Okay, if someone has three beers, are they of sound mind? It depends on the guy. No, you know what it depends on? My documentation. It depends on how I documented it and my conversation with the nurse and how did they document it. So obviously, guys, people can have a couple beers and they're not legal to drive, but legal to drive does not determine sound mind. Be very careful chasing blood alcohol contents. Who determines sound mind? I do. Okay? Now, just as a pro tip, someone comes in, they had a few beers. You want to run some tests, they say no. Now, you document, patient openly admits to having alcohol. Patient is of sound mind by my evaluation based on bop, 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 and just start saying they're speaking in full speech. They're not slurring their words. They're making sense. They're talking logically. They understand the risks and the benefits. Now, I will go talk to the nurse and say, wait, do you feel the patients have sound mind? Do you feel they're able to make decisions? Because you better make sure your notes correlated with theirs. If the nurse feels that way, I will say, please make sure you document that, okay? Now, if they decide, hey, I don't want to run any tests, I want to go home. If they're alert and of sound mind, goodbye. My note says something like this. My note says, at this time, There's no threat to self or others that would make me infringe on this patient's civil rights and proceed with an involuntary evaluation. Therefore, patient will be discharged, patient's not driving, and therefore safe to be discharged. You put something like that on, oh, I'm not gonna volunteer, I'm not gonna violate his civil rights. That looks so good documentation. No lawyer wants anything to do with that. Okay, informed consent, adult year sound mind. Now talk about implied consent. All right, well, who gets implied consent? Well, people who are not of adult years or they're not of sound mind, okay? So implied consent implies to, would any reasonable person want to be taken care of right now? So I'll say it this way, in a life, limb, or vision threatening emergency, you can do anything you want to help them because it's implied. So if a kid is 14 years old, he falls off his bike, hurts his knee. So you're working urgent care, kid falls off his bike, hurts his knee. Their friends come in and the nurse comes back and says, 14-year-old fell off his bike and hurt his knee. We can't reach the parents. Should you see the kid? Should you evaluate the kid? What do you think? It is tricky. I agree with you, sir. I agree. It's a tricky scenario. I'll tell you what my scenario is, what my advice is. Who determines if there's a life, limb, or vision-threatening injury? I do. I'm seeing everybody. Everybody gets seen. Everybody gets a chart. I'm seeing them. Everybody. And I'm going to evaluate them and basically say, I've done a medical screening exam. At this time, there's no life, limb, or vision-threatening injuries. Therefore, no further evaluation or treatment will take place until we get informed consent. It's bulletproof. It's bulletproof. If the parents look at it and if they refuse the charge, I don't blame them. Good for them. It's not personal. Hey, but I'm seeing them because guess what? Here's what I would tell you. Let's just say it's his son who fell off the bike. Okay, I'd want to take care of your son just like I want you to take care of my son. And I'm going to evaluate him. Guess what? If the bone's tenting the skin, okay, that's a limb threatening. If he hit his head, and I don't think he's acting right, that's life-threatening. If he's got a neck injury, that's life-threatening. How can I know? I'm not going to trust a nurse. No disrespect to the nurse. If I don't see him, I don't know. Cool? So there's informed or implied. Be aware, anybody who comes in and they have sexual-related questions or sexual-related issues, can't tell the parents. Just be aware of that. I'm going to ask you guys a question, and I got to be honest. I misunderstood this, and I do believe it's dependent on state. Patient comes in, 18-year-old male, urethral discharge. He's got chlamydia. He said, listen, I just started dating a girl. She's not going to come in. Can you prescribe antibiotics for the girl without seeing her? I'm just telling you, it was my understanding that if you didn't see a patient have a documented chart, you couldn't. But I also know in North Carolina, you absolutely can, and there's laws protecting you. So I would say that's more state dependent than anything. I would just say, just know what your state laws are. Okay, let me keep going, keep going. So basically, informed consent of adult years and sound mind. Implied consent is anybody who life, limb, or vision threatening injury. So if someone falls off their bike, and they're 17, and they become hypotensive, and they have a belly pain, you can take them to the OR. You don't have to get any consent. That's they're going to die if you don't. Cool?